do anything for his girl, and he's the kind of lover every girl eventually would want, you know, who's head over heels and who's protective, and I think that's why Preeti falls in love with him.
Or you can remove the Pirashian part and just stick to the first three letters. That could also apply to a certain phase of Kabir. Samajh mein aaya, samajh mein aaya. He could be one sometimes.
Yeah.
Aspirational, mein se pirational nikal.
Right, but tell me, for you, because you've played this character, you've lived this character, what are the qualities of Kabir as a lover that you feel most connected to?
Loyalty.
Yeah, he's just like a nice cute puppy. Very loyal. Women like that, don't they? Loyal puppies.
Are you?
No, I think Kabir is a very flawed character. But the reason you can make a film about him is because he's a very real character and he loves very purely. And the best thing about the character is that he's a combination of aggression and vulnerability. And those are two completely opposite kind of emotions, but he draws that kind of reaction out of you, which makes him very unique, and that's what was very appealing to me. I think he can be very extreme as a lover, and that's the part that can be damaging for people. But he also loves very purely, and he can dedicate himself to somebody else, and I think that's a very rare quality in people, especially these days. You don't find it so often. And I think that's aspirational. But the way he deals with certain things, I would definitely not suggest. And I would say Kabir Singh is quite hanikarak for your sihat. So, you know, but films are about showcasing reality and showing all phases of a human being's life. I mean, if you don't see black, how do you know the difference between white and black? You have to show black for white to stand out. So Kabir is like that, like all of us, you know. That's your job, no? If I start critiquing my own character, I won't be able to be him.
Because you are the actor.
Yeah, my role is to represent him honestly and to play him for how he is. And it's for you to decide which part of him you liked, which part of him you didn't like. Because see, good and bad is a part of life. But what's most important is the intent. You know, we all make mistakes. I mean, when I speak to my friends or I speak to my family, it's not about what you did. We all make mistakes, we all behave badly. But if the intent behind that is to hurt someone deliberately or to do something negative, then that's not something that one can appreciate. But if it's coming from a good place, but you're behaving badly, which also happens, you know. So the intent is most important for me when I view a character. And I think Kabir has very pure intent. But because he's flawed, he behaves in different ways. And that's why he's a character that probably is worth watching on the big screen, because he has the ability to surprise you and he has the ability to, you know, make impact because of the way that he is. At least that's how I saw it. When it comes to love stories, I don't really look for logic. I look for magic, you know. If you feel like it was magical, if you feel like it made you feel romantic, it made you remember those moments when your heart was full of feelings and you know, so I think it's about bringing that kind of you know, that mood in the audience, and I felt that this film had that energy because of just how raw and real it was. Having said that, I've always said that Kabir is the more, you know, everybody's been saying shayad ka strong character hai, kya ji aapka thoda subtle character hai, to aapko kaisa laga? You know, I really feel Preeti is a much stronger character in the film. Kabir is actually the weaker character, because people who are stronger are less reactive and people who are weaker are actually more reactive. And Kabir is not responding. See, there's a big difference between response and reaction. When you respond, you've thought it through and then you respond. When you react, it's just an immediate reaction. And Kabir is very reactive. So to me, Kabir is the vulnerable, flawed guy deep inside who looks very aggressive on the outside. And Kiara is the much stronger, much more stable character on the inside who looks more vulnerable on the outside. And to me, that's actually the coolest part about this film and how the characters have been interpreted. And so, she is the stability in Kabir's life. Preeti is the stability in Kabir's life.
What is it that Kabir loves in Preeti or likes in her?
And I remember asking my director the same question. I said, but why does Kabir, you know, why is it that one moment that, like, what is it in her? What is so special about her? She's a simple girl, and what is this? So he said, think about it. Think about any time you've been in love. What is that? Have you ever had that defining moment where when you've seen someone said, I feel like talking to her, I feel like messaging her today or him today? Or initially, when you start off, it's never like that. There's not something that we do that that makes you want to talk to the person. Like he said, it's that magic. And in real life, it's easy to create it on screen, and sometimes it's tricky, you know? It's like, how do you know? How do you know it's going to happen? And I think, but that was the beauty of this particular story, because otherwise you always see films and you say, acha ladki ne bachcho ko bachaya, and suddenly the boy sees it and she's fallen in love, and you're always trying to make a reason for it. But there's no real reason. You can never define that moment when, what is it in a person that, you know, attracts you to? Yes, eventually then you, like, falling in love with a person, it may take a month, a few days, who knows, it may be first sight. But that initial thing that draws you to a person, you can never define that moment. And I felt things like this, which were so unspoken, was just so magical to see in a Hindi, in, you know, an Indian film. So yeah, I just wanted to add that.
But we have less love stories in Bollywood. We have had less love stories of late. I remember asking, someone asked Shrimita also that how, you know, the face of love has changed over the years, and so has Hindi cinema's way of approaching it. So you think the quintessential love stories, we don't have them anymore?
So on one hand, I think there was a time when we only used to focus on love stories. So if you compare it in relative terms, yeah, there are very few love stories happening today. The good thing about that is that good stories are being told today, and they don't have to be love stories to be, you know, universal or, you know, overseas maybe chal jayegi, or young youth audience aa jayegi, and you know, all that, you know, stuff that you used to hear. Thank God that that time is gone where we are obsessed with love stories and we can't think beyond love stories.
You were the face of it.
Yeah, I have gone through a phase where a few of them have really done well. But I was always trying to break out with the Kamines and the Heathers, and I was always trying to break out, you know, because I was actually really not that excited about love stories. Because I just felt like love story ke chakkar mein 5-6 gaane aa jaate hain, 2-3 mountain aa jaate hain, ek Swiss Alps ka ek, you know, ek round ho jata hai, aur usme se 50 mein se ek achhi hoti hai, baki 49 are disappointment. I'd rather take that money and put it in another story which deserves to be told. Why are we so obsessed with just this one genre, you know? And it's very unhealthy for any genre when people start making too many of those, because then people get sick of the genre. It's not the fault of the genre, it's actually the fault of the crappy films that are coming out, which are putting you off about the genre, you know? So on one hand, I think it's really healthy that today we're making films of all types and of all genres, because of which today you are asking this question. You know, it's so refreshing after such a long time, a love story. So there's something refreshing about the genre. It's always good that that happens. Having said that, I think also sometimes, you know, we make this mistake of, like when you saw Titanic, you remember how you felt when you saw Titanic? So love is timeless. We should not start assuming and start sending this message out in society ki aajkal to pyar hota hi nahi hai, pyar bada fast hota hai, pyar bada frivolous hota hai, to frivolous si ek film bana lo, koi meaning wali film mat banao, uske andar kuch emotion mat dalo, kuch intensity mat dalo, kuch drama mat dalo. Love is only fluffy, so let's make stupid fluffy films about love. You know, that's the mindset which we're in right now. That is not unhealthy. I think if a love story must be substantial. And I think our favorite love stories over time have been very substantial in their content. You know, the drama has been substantial, the relationships have been substantial, the characters have been memorable, well written, well executed, taken you through the entire, you know, array of emotions where you feel happy when they meet for the first time, then you get nostalgic, ki mere saath bhi aisa hua tha. You know, then you get worried what's going to happen with these characters, and then hopefully you walk out with a smile on your face. So some tragedies also have done very well. You know, so I think love stories are a very elite kind of genre and should not be attempted too much. Only people who are qualified and have something worthy of sharing should attempt love stories.
So when people with Ashad has gone through that phase about love stories, did you ever have that concern about debut or having that hero or heroine moment of being that love story or the heroine? Ever, when you were dreaming of becoming a Bollywood actress, you mentioned this book? I mean, every Bollywood, anyone who aspires to be a Hindi film heroine wants that. I did a film called Machine, which was a bit like that. None of you all saw it. But it was a bit like that. And I really personally enjoyed it. And I mean, the experience. But I feel this is something that I could connect to much more. It's very difficult to even do something like that. I think it takes a lot. It takes a lot of conviction. To make that ideal love story. And I think the beauty of a love story which is so real is that in 2019 we can all connect to that, and it's still timeless, it's still so passionate, but at the same time, because it's so flawed, it seems more real and more relatable. So I would say this is my dream love story that I would have wanted to be a part of, and I'm lucky and glad and blessed that they came to me.
I think films are a reflection of life, films are a reflection of society, films are a reflection of the state of mind of the Aam Aadmi, right? So I think in the 80s and 90s, India was a developing nation. It had not developed and it had not reached its potential. I think today we are one of the fastest growing economies in the world, and the middle class today has the spending power. Sorry, I'm digressing, I'll come to your point. You know, so the newer theatres, the wider theatres are going into the tier 2, tier 3 cities. So the composition of the audience has changed in the last 20 years, which means that the kind of content that they want, the percentages of that has got divided. You know, in the 80s and 90s, we used to want to see abroad. We didn't have the money to go abroad, so we wanted to see a movie in which they take you abroad and you can experience that. Today, that's not a problem. You can travel, you can go to places, it's much easier for you. There's Instagram, there's Facebook, you know what's happening everywhere in the world. So the fact that we are making real films today is because I think we moved out of that phase of wanting to experience things that we don't have the money or the means to achieve. Therefore, aspirational love stories, therefore characters who are perfect, because we are wanting to view movies as something that yaar jo aam zindagi mein nahi hota na, wo humko dekhne ko mil jayega. It was like, you know, like how kids go to a candy store, wow, this is so nice. But I think today we're in a place where we take ourselves seriously, and the audience has enough exposure. They don't need movies to give them experiences that they can't have personally. So they want movies to talk about things that matter to them. I also think the audience today is a lot more evolved than they were 25 years back, and therefore they want to be taken seriously. So I think you need to take the audience today very seriously. You can't. There was a time when you used to say, you know, aisa karo to audience ko achha lag jayega, waisa karo to audience ko achha lag jayega. Nobody should say that anymore. We should just make something honest and hope that people will appreciate the effort that you've made. And yeah, so I think people are much more intelligent, much more into real things and reality. There was a time when actors used to be inaccessible.